नमस्कार। वेलकम टू ज्ञानीज वर्ल्ड। In Critical Analysis of Veda Season 1 Episode 3 Part 1, we have watched the About the Eternality of Vedas. Now in this Episode 3 Part 2 again, let us see about the eternality of Vedas. Before we continue, kindly like, share, subscribe and press the bell icon for more updates. Dear viewers of Gnani's World, before we get into the subject, let us watch a small video clip of Kamakshi Dhanraj.
We need substantial, historically and archaeologically verifiable proofs to accept these ideas as truth. Does Christianity have such proofs? Well, it's time to examine that.
Dear viewers of Gnani's World, for those people who don't know about Kamakshi Dhanraj, she was a Brahmin, introduces herself to the world as an ex-Christian and works for intellectual Kshatriya team of proud American Rajiv Malhotra, who promoted rape accused Nityananda, and final result everyone knows. In her video clip, she raised some good logical objections to Christians, saying, "We need substantial, historically and archaeologically verifiable proofs to accept these ideas as truth. Does Christianity have such proofs? Well, it is time to examine that." And Gnani's World tried to apply her own logical objection to the Vedas and try to get the answers for the eternality of the Vedas, that is, are Vedas really eternal? Here we go. Majority of the Hindu scholars of Vedas accept that the Vedas are eternal and beginningless. This they try to explain only by mere conjecture and some philosophical gymnastics. As far as the tangible evidence is concerned, there is no reason to believe in this myth of Vedas being eternal. Gnani's World will analyze this topic from many angles and thus build a coherent view that Vedas are of a finite date. When the finite age of the Vedas are established, it will bring to rest many false theories and questions that are built on the supposition that Vedas are eternal. The methodology to analyze the claim whether the Vedas are eternal or not is to check the linguistic evidence. If the Vedic language Sanskrit has itself originated from another language, or both originated from a common language, then Vedas will be disproved to be eternal. Internal evidence. What do Vedas say? If the Vedas never claimed to be eternal and from the beginning, but the internal evidence shows that Vedas were written at a finite date, then also this claim of Vedas being eternal will collapse. Are Vedic teachings valid or obsolete? Those who uphold this view of eternity of Vedas also claim that Vedic teachings are for all times. Thus, if it can be shown that Vedic teachings are obsolete or time-bound, the claim of eternity of Vedas will fall apart. And finally, Zoroastrian sources of Vedas. If many teachings and concepts within the Vedas are similar to those of Zoroastrian religion, then why should we not conclude that Vedic religion has been derived from Zoroastrianism? Because the Parsi Zoroastrians consider their religion older than the Vedic religion. Now, dear viewers of Gnani's World, in the part 1 video, we analyzed the linguistic evidence and internal evidence to prove Vedas are not eternal. Now, in this part 2 video, let us investigate, are Vedic teachings valid or obsolete? And Zoroastrian sources of Vedas. First, let us investigate, are Vedic teachings valid or obsolete? If the Vedic teachings are obsolete, then they are not eternal. Now I wish to explore whether the teachings of the Vedas are applicable for all times or not. The main principle of religion is to make a disciplined individual with an exceptional morality. A book which is upheld as a constitution for human living must provide ways of knowing God, of worship, of handling worldly affairs, social system, solid principles for a clean culture. However, when we study the Vedas, we find it devoid for all these points. Rig Veda mentions numerous gods, devtas. When it mentions Agni, we feel that Agni is the supreme deity and no other is equal to Agni. But when we read about Indra, we feel Indra is supreme and no one is comparable to Indra. In total, there are 33 gods that are divided into three categories. 11 of the heavens, 11 of earth, and 11 of water. Later, these 33 gods increased in numbers and became 330 million. The whole 9th mandal book of Rig Veda has ended with praising Soma Juice, Somaras. The Soma god Devta is on the same level as Agni. There has been a dispute concerning the Soma Juice between traditional Sanskrit scholar and Swami Dayanand. Some say it is the name of wine, some consider it as bhang, a preparation from the leaves and flowers of the female cannabis plant. Swami Dayanand and his followers say that Soma was a plant used to make an energizing drink, but surprisingly it has become extinct and we cannot find it anywhere today. This implies that an entire mandal book of Rig Veda has become useless. I will give you extracts on various topics from the Vedas so that you may yourself access the level of its teaching about Soma Juice. Those desiring to perform yajna, fire ritual, have given you Soma from the waters. That Soma is majestic, imperishable, having a lot of hair on it and oblique on the edge. Rig Veda Mandal 1, Sukta 135, Mantra 6. Notice that the mantra calls Soma as imperishable, Nash Rahit, and Arya Samaj and other scholars say that it has perished. So either they must accept that this Vedic mantra has been proven false or accept that the Vedas are promoting crime, because the only option left for them is that Soma is wine or bhang, both intoxicating substances. Like the mantra above, there are numerous other mantras encouraging people to drink Soma juice, also known as bhang. So you can yourself access what kind of a book will promote this vice, and can it be considered a divine scripture? Some of the other mantras of Rig Veda mentioning Soma are given here. These show that at the time of the writings of Vedas, Soma juice, also known as bhang, was consumed a lot. Encouraging and glorifying robbers, dacoits, murderers, cheaters, and looters. Homage to the conquering, piercing lord of his sailing bands. Homage to the towering sword bearer. To the master of thieves, homage. Homage to the gliding robber. To the roamer. To the master of forest, homage. Homage to the cheat. To the arch deceiver, the master of stealer, homage. Homage to the wearer of sword and favor. To the master of robbers, homage. Homage to the bolt-armed murderer. To the master of thieves, homage. Homage to the sword bearer. To those who roam at night, to the master of looters, homage. To the turban-wearing haunters of mountains, master of land grabbers, homage. Homage to you who bear arrows and to you who carry bows. Homage to you with bent bows and to you who adjust your arrows. To you who draw and bow and to you who stood, be homage. Homage to you who let fly and to you who pierce. Homage to you who sleep and to you who wake. Homage to you who lie and to you who sit. Homage to you who stand and to you who run. Yajurveda Adhyay 16 Mantras 20-23. What kind of a book will pay homage to looters, dacoits, land grabbers, thieves and murderers? Can this book be a guide for humanity? Notice that the Sanskrit word that has been translated as homage is nama. So there are no doubts about the fact that Vedas glorify crimes and criminals. Sorry for being offensive, but the text is clear. So those religious fanatics like Kamakshi Dhanraj who unnecessarily point fingers at Christianity should check their own books. Even after these passages from Vedics have been presented, can any anti-Christian religious fanatics dare to claim Vedic teachings as eternal? These teachings can in no way be accepted. Dear viewers of Nani's World, now let us investigate the Zoroastrian sources of Vedas. Sun occupied a very significant position in the religion of ancient Persian and Zendavesta. Similarly, at various places in the Vedas, sun god Surya Devta occupies a significant position. Rig Veda Mandal 4, Sukta 14. In the Zendavesta, god Mitra is glorified as, I announce and carry out this yajna for Mitra of white pastures, of the thousand years and of the myriad eyes. Yajna 1-3. Similarly, Mitra is glorified in Rig Veda 359. Mitra, when speaking, stirreth man to labor. Mitra sustaineth both the earth and heaven. Mitra beholdeth men with eyes that close not. To Mitra bring with holy oil oblation. Vayudevta is mentioned in both Zendavasta and Vedas. See for example Yasna 25.5. Yama is mentioned throughout the Zendavasta and so is Yamaraja mentioned in the Vedas. He has same roles in both the scriptures, that is, the ruler of the dead. Trita is called the first healer in Avesta Vanidat, Fargad 20. Similarly, Trita Aptya is mentioned as healer in the Vedas. In Zendavasta, especially in its Hom Yash section, Homa is described as a herb and worthy of worship. Similarly, as we have seen before, Soma is called a herb and deserving worship. For details, see Hom Yash in Avesta Yasna and Rig Veda Mandal 9, Som Mandal. Agni is taken as an object of worship in both scriptures. The methods of sacrifice, worship and the words used in the worship are so strikingly similar that were I to reproduce here those passages, it can make a voluminous book. To illustrate, I will provide only one example of how similar the prayers to Mitra are. We offer up libations unto Mitra, the Lord of white pastures, who gives a happy dwelling and a good dwelling to the Aryan nations. May he come to us for help. May he come to us for ease. May he come to us for joy. May he come to us for mercy. May he come to us for health. May he come to us for victory. May he come to us for good conscience. May he come to us for bliss. He the awful and overpowering, worthy of sacrifice and prayer, not to be deceived anywhere in the whole of the material world. Mitra, the Lord of white pastures. Koda Avesta 10, Mayur Yash 4-5. Mitra of holy strength, I call and for destroying Varuna who make the oil-fed rite complete. Mitra and Varuna, through law, lovers and cherishers of law, have ye obtained your might, power, as sages. Mitra Varuna, wide dominion, strong by birth, vouchsafe his strength that worketh well. Rig Veda Mandal 1, Sukta 2, Mantra 7-9. Dear viewers of Nani's World, from the above analysis, any logical person can conclude that the claim of Vedas being eternal is mere a hoax, and moreover, they cannot be ultimate guidebook for humanity. May God always guide us to the truth and keep us firm on it. Dear viewers, people like Kamakshi Dhanraj may come and go, but what matters is the truth, the absolute truth. Think for a while, everything is in black and white. You decide what to choose. So viewers, stay tuned for episode 4 of season 1 to do analysis of fake translation of saga of Vedas mantras. Request to follow us on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, Pinterest and Reddit. Kindly subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon for more updates. Thank you.